The Biden administration could be giving the U.S. economy millions, still trying to pay off their loans. Alicia Nieves shows us how this would work and how likely this is to happen.
President-elect Joe Biden campaigned on a promise to forgive some student loan debt, and now millions of Americans are hopeful that will happen shortly after he takes office.
I think it is one of the most accessible ways that President-elect Joe Biden has to stimulate the economy.
Suzanne Kahn is the Director of Education, Jobs, and Worker Power at the Roosevelt Institute and says Biden has two choices for immediate student loan forgiveness. One, push for Congress to include it in the next stimulus package. He's currently doing that and pushing for $10,000 to be forgiven. Two, if Congress doesn't include it in the stimulus package, Biden can issue an executive order by authority given to him in the Higher Education Act. Either option could eliminate student loan debt for roughly 15 million borrowers and reduce the debt of another 30 million Americans.
It is most likely through executive action, or at least the first movement we'll see around it is through executive action. That's really just because the federal government owns 95% of student debt and the Secretary of Education has the ability to cancel it.
I mean, my sense is it's not inevitable.
Neil McCluskey is the director of the Center for Educational Freedom at the Cato Institute and says student loan forgiveness, especially through executive order, could be the most controversial way to go.
There seems to be straws that certainly he can grab and say, look, this gives me authority to just sort of write off this debt. Other people say it's not clear in the law that he can do that. And so if he were to try to cancel debt through executive action, it would probably end up in court and it would be a pretty long court battle.
So if you're at home wondering what this means for your student loan debt, ultimately, it is now more likely than ever before that some of your debt could be forgiven, but still nowhere close to guaranteed.
I don't think it's inevitable, but I do think it is exciting that it's on the table and, frankly, important that it's on the table.
I'm Alicia Nieves reporting.
48 attorneys general, including Michigan's.